Okay.
It's your boy Rick MOHAMED, Brawlers Sports Media in the building, and my associates 3KingsBoxing.com. I'm live here with my man from Chicago, Harvey, Illinois, Shawndell Winners. Got a big opportunity tomorrow night on the undercard of the Mikey Garcia, Jesse Vargas on Matchbox The Zone. And he is taking on Joseph Parker. This is a big opportunity for you and your family, man. You're always coming in as the underdog, but you find a way to win and get that W. So now, look at God has blessed you to be in the position that you're in. Tell the fans back at home, man, what can they expect from you and who you are and how you got here?
Well, you definitely right about that. I'm definitely a family man. And it's definitely by God's grace and mercy how I'm here. Out of the desert, if you will, getting, you know, things together. And I feel like right now, you know, everything is peaking at the proper time. What you can expect from me on Saturday night is blood, sweat, and tears. I come there to bring it all, you know what I mean? I bring everything that I have, you know, to the ring, and I don't leave anything in the locker room or the gym.
Yeah.
I'm gonna leave it all in the ring, and I look to have my hand raised on Saturday night.
And I asked you just earlier about the weight difference, you know, that he weighed in 245, you weigh in at 208, but that don't mean anything. As long as you utilize your skill set, keep touching and sticking him with that jab, that weight doesn't mean anything, because I'm quite sure that you're sparring way bigger guys than 208.
This is true. I have Nick the Terror Asbury, Michael Ola. I got so many great sparring partners and guys who are all like 6'4", 6'5", 6'6", 240, 250. And these are strong guys that can punch real quick.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of them are athletes, you know, or other sport athletes before boxing. And they all younger guys, all of, you know, 21 to like 26, 27.
Yeah.
So, you know, I have that advantage as well. You know, I be in the ring, I share the ring all the time with larger guys. And, you know, I hold my own. And I've been able and fortunate enough in this camp to prepare well. And I'm just, like I said, I'm looking to put on an explosive, exciting performance Saturday night.
That's what's up. Any concerns real quick that you have for Parker or any predictions that you would like to make?
Concerns, I can't say that. Like I said, in Chicago, we spar three weight classes up, three weight classes down.
Okay.
So I've been in the ring with guys 168 pounds, 175 pounds, and up to heavyweight.
Okay.
So I'm not concerned with speed. I'm not concerned with power. I've been in the ring with big punchers. I've been in the ring with guys that have speed.
Uh-huh.
I use a lot of angles. I use boxing intelligence.
Uh-huh.
And the number one attribute is God is on my side, but also
amen.
I could fight.
Yeah.
You know, I come up hard.
Yeah.
You know, I had to fight.
Because I'm streets, boy.
You know what I'm saying? I could fight. So the thing is, I'm not really thinking about Joseph Parker as far as what he brings to the table. I'm going to make him, you know, worry about what I bring to the table.
That's what's up. Real quick in closing, I'm going to let you get back to your rest, champ. Wilder Fury 2, everybody's talking about it. What's your take on it? Did the fight go the way you anticipated it that it would? And what would your advice be to Wilder and his team, being that he's our brother and everything, you know what I mean? And thank God that he came out of that okay to go home and be able to take care of him and his family. What would your advice be?
The way that I saw the fight, I can't really say how I saw it. I'm just a fan of the sport. Yeah. So when I watched the fight, I watched it, you know, like everybody else. I could tell by Fury putting on the extra weight that he wasn't necessarily looking to box.
Yeah.
So, you know, I can't say what...